Hey, math class. I just wanted to give you a tip about solving multiplication problems. I don't know if you're finding as we're working through them that you're having some issue with sort of keeping things straight. I know that whenever I do multiplication problems, I always end up sort of getting my columns all confused. And a great way to avoid that is by using graph paper. So I just wanted to give you an example of how you could use the graph paper and how it might be helpful for you. So as you can see here, I've put each one number in each little box, and the reason for that is now I can see that, you know, the columns all line up. It will help me keep everything organized. So if I was going to solve this problem, I can simply cover up that 2, right, and not really think about that, and just solve the 27 times 3, or the 7 times 3, which is 21, and I'm going to carry the 2, and then 3 times 2 is 6, plus 2, 8, okay? So when you only have one number on the bottom, you know, maybe it's not as helpful, but problems that look like this are where I really think that it gets to be helpful. Because you have two numbers on the bottom, you're going to have a placeholder at some point. Things can sometimes get a little, crazy. So, okay, let's look at this. So the first thing I'm going to do is simply ignore this one, because I am going to just work with the 2. So 2 times 3, 6. 2 times 1, 2. 2 times 9, 18. Ta-da! And so now we can see clearly where we need to put our placeholder, because remember, we need to jump over one spot. I usually put an X, because that's how I was taught the first time that I learned how to multiply. But you might also use a 0. And all that means is now I'm going to ignore this 2 and jump over and just deal with the 1. So let's look at that now. I mean, 1 times anything is pretty simple. And now, instead of having something that sort of kind of goes off to the side, like in a kind of, you know, in unclear columns, we have a very clear thing here that we can see that, oh, 6 plus 0 is 6, 2 plus 3 is 5, 8 plus 1 is 9, 9 and 1 is 10. We can easily see what needs to be added with what. Here is, there it is, another example of this. So again, I've got 3 numbers on the bottom. I have a lot that I'm going to have to keep track of. So I'm going to start by just multiplying with the 3s, and I'm going to ignore the 0 and the 5 for right now. Okay, so 7 times 3, 21. 3 times 1 is 3, plus 2, 5. 3 times 1, 3. Okay, placeholder. Now I'm going to deal with the 0. 0 times 7 is 0. 0 times 1 is 0. 0 times 1, 0. Now, since I'm jumping over to the 5, I have to put in 2 placeholders, right? 5 times 7, 35. 5 times 1 is 5, plus 3, 8. 5 plus 1 is 5. And now I can, as you can see, easily add all of these together. 1 plus 2 zeros is 1. 5 plus 3 is 8. 8, 5. And I can easily see there that my answer is 58,851. So if this you find is helpful, it's something that you want to try, please let me know. I always have graph paper with me. And also, too, you'll see we'll use graph paper a lot when it comes to dividing as well, when we get to that next week. So anyway, hopefully this was beneficial and you can see the great benefits of using graph paper.